In this video, we're going to start the CUDA Software Infinite Geometry Free Worksheet Circle Constructions. In numbers 1 and 2, we're going to be locating the center of each circle. In order to do that, we're going to start with our straight edge and make a chord along the circle. Our next step is we're going to draw the perpendicular bisector of that chord. And in doing so, we will cut the circle in half. Remember, in order to create the perpendicular bisector, you're going to move your compass a little more than half the distance between the two points of the segment that you're trying to bisect. We're going to make a mark to each side from one end point, and then from the other end point, we're going to make two more marks, one on each side of the chord. Now, we will connect those intersection points, splitting the circle in half. Now, we're going to find the midpoint of the segment we just created, and that will be the center of our circle. In order to find the midpoint, we're going to find the perpendicular bisector. So starting from one end point, making sure our compass is a little more than halfway, we're going to strike a mark to each side of the line. And then from the other end point, we're going to make marks on each side of the line again. Now we will be able to connect those two intersection points. And the point where that perpendicular line bisects or intersects our previous line, that is the center of the circle. Let's move on to number 2. In number 2, remember we're going to start with a chord. And then we're going to find the perpendicular bisector of that chord. Once we find the intersections, we'll draw our line to make that perpendicular bisector. Now we're going to find the perpendicular bisector of the line we just created in order to find that midpoint, which will be the center of our circle. Making sure our compass is a little more than half of that distance from end point to end point, we will make marks from each end point on each side of that segment. Now let's draw that perpendicular bisector. And there is our center point. Now in number 3 and 4, it says to construct a line segment tangent to the circle through the given point. Now in order to do this, we're going to start by drawing a line that connects that point to the center of the circle, which they give us our center point, so no need to find that. Because that given point is on the edge of the circle, I'm going to extend that line that connects the center point to the given point out. Now because it's on the edge, I know that a tangent line will intersect it perpendicularly, or at 90 degrees. So I'm going to find the distance from the center point to that midpoint, and then mark that outside of my circle from that given point to the segment that I drew. Now I'm going to find the perpendicular bisector of this segment length, knowing that this point on the edge of the circle is in the center of that line, since this distance is congruent to this distance. Now in order to find the perpendicular bisector, I'm going to extend my compass a little more than half the distance from end point to end point, and I only need to make a mark to one side since I have that midpoint already. The intersection connected with the midpoint will give me my tangent line. So this is my line segment tangent to the circle through that given point. Let's move on to number 4. In number 4, I'm going to start again by connecting my given point to my center point. Now I'm going to find the perpendicular bisector of this segment. Making sure my compass is a little more than half that distance, I'll start at the center point, make my marks to each side of that segment, and then from the given point, I'll make my marks to each side of that segment. Now I'm making this perpendicular bisector in order to find the midpoint. And once I find that midpoint, I will take the distance on my compass from the midpoint to the center of the circle. And then from there, I'll create an arc that goes through the edges of the circle. Now, where that arc intersects my circle are the points that will lie on my tangent lines. So connecting my given point to one intersection of the circle, and then connecting my given point to the other intersection, I will create my two tangent segments. Let's continue on to the second page. On the second page, for numbers 5 and 6, we're going to circumscribe a circle about each rectangle. And in order to do this, we need to find the center of the rectangle. Now remember, for a rectangle, opposite sides are congruent. So this side is congruent to this side, and this side is congruent to this side. So we're going to find the perpendicular of two separate sides that are not congruent. So first, looking at this top side, I'm going to make a mark to each side of the line. And then from the other end point, or other vertex on our rectangle, I'll make two more marks, and it will be the perpendicular bisector of both segments. Because remember, they are congruent, and since all the corners are at 90 degrees, they're also parallel. Now, let's find the perpendicular bisector of this other side. Now I'll connect those intersections to form my perpendicular bisector. Now the point at which those two lines intersect will be the center of my circle. So now I'll take my compass, place it in the center, and then place it on any corner or any vertex within my rectangle. And you can see that indeed it is the same distance to each. So now I'll draw my circle going through each point, going through each of the vertices. And there is my circle in number 5. Let's look at number 6. In number 6, again, remember opposite sides are congruent and parallel. Therefore, when we find the perpendicular bisector of one side, we'll also find it for the side opposite. So finding my first perpendicular bisector, and then finding my second perpendicular bisector. Now that I've located the center of my rectangle, I can go from the center to one of my vertices of my rectangle and draw my circle. And there is my circle in number 6. Now, number 7, it says to construct a circle that passes through the given points. And we need to do the same for number 8. Note that we have three separate points, which if we connect those three points, we'll form a triangle. We're going to be circumscribing a circle about the triangle. And remember, in order to do that, we need to find the intersection of perpendicular bisectors. So we'll find the perpendicular bisector of this side and this side. Making our compass a little more than halfway, we'll draw a mark to each side of the segment, and then going from the other end point of that same segment, we'll draw two more marks, one to each side. That intersection will help us form our perpendicular bisector. Now, for the second side of our triangle. And remember, we only need to do two because the perpendicular bisectors will all intersect at the same point. So making our compass a little more than halfway, I'll strike a mark to each side of this line segment. Now I'll draw a line from those intersections to form my perpendicular bisector. Now the point in which those perpendicular bisectors intersect, I will be able to put my compass and it will be equidistant from each of the points. Now I will just construct my circle. And you can see that it indeed passes through each of those three points. So let's repeat this process for number 8. For number 8, I'll find the perpendicular bisector of this side and this side. So I'm not even going to draw my third side of the triangle. finding my perpendicular bisector of that first side, the shorter side, I'll make my marks that are the same distance from each of my edge points in order to form that perpendicular bisector. Now, finding the perpendicular bisector of my next segment, I'll connect those intersections to find the center point of my circle. Now I'm going to erase a little bit of the extra marks so that it's easier to see when I draw my circle. Placing my compass at that center point and adjusting it so that it reaches one other point, I will then draw my circle. And making my points a little darker, you can see that indeed the circle intersects each of those three points. Now let's continue on. In number 9, we're going to circumscribe a circle about this triangle. So remember, in order to do this, we're going to find the perpendicular bisector of at least two sides. And where those intersect, that will be the center of our circle. So let's find the perpendicular bisector of this shorter side. Making our compass a little more than half the distance from end point to end point, we'll mark above, below, above, and below. Now connecting those intersections will form our perpendicular bisector. Now let's find this perpendicular bisector of the side on the left, making our compass so that it measures slightly more than half the distance between those two endpoints. We'll make marks to one side of the line, the other side of the line from that same endpoint, switch to the other endpoint, and make those two marks again. Now the intersection points of those intersected arcs will be two points on our perpendicular bisector. So we'll just connect those in order to form our perpendicular bisector. Now, where those intersect, that will be the center of our circle. So taking our compass from that center point, we'll be able to place it on a vertex, and it will be the same distance to each vertice of our triangle. So now we'll just draw the circle. And that's how you circumscribe a circle about a triangle. Now, in our last problem on this worksheet, we're going to be inscribing a circle in a triangle. However, before I go over the method for doing this, please remember to like this video and subscribe to my channel. All likes and subscriptions are greatly appreciated. Also, if you found this video helpful, feel free to share it with your peers. Now, at number 10, in order to inscribe a circle, we first have to find the intersection of two angle bisectors. So we'll look at this angle and that angle, our bottom two angles. Remember, in order to find the angle bisector, we'll draw a mark on each segment that makes up the angle, making sure it's the marks are the same distance from that vertex, and then from those intersections, we'll make a mark inside of that angle and find that intersection point. From that intersection point, we'll be able to create our angle bisector. Now let's look at our other angle. Now we'll find this angle bisector. Now the point at which those intersect is important. Let me go ahead and erase all our work we've done so far, with the exclusion of that point. Now our next step, after we find the intersection of two angle bisectors, we're going to need to draw a line that's perpendicular to one side of the triangle that runs through that point we've just created. So let's draw it perpendicular to this side here. In order to do that, we're going to take our compass and make two marks along that side of the triangle that are the same distance from that point. So here's one intersection point, and here's another intersection point. Now I will find the perpendicular bisector of the segment created by those two endpoints. So making sure my compass is a little more than halfway, I'll mark to one side of the line from each endpoint because that intersection is going to be perpendicular to this segment, but it's going to go through the point of intersection of our angle bisectors. So this was an important step because the point where that perpendicular bisector intersects the triangle, from that point to the intersection of our angle bisectors, that length is the radius of our circle coming from that center point. So what we're going to do now is we're going to take our compass, place it on our center point, and then place it on the intersection of that perpendicular line. And when we draw our circle, you can see that it will be inscribed within that triangle. So repeating the steps again, we found the intersection of angle bisectors, and that intersection is the center point of our triangle. However, we needed to then create a line perpendicular to a side through that point in order to find the radius of our circle. And then once we took that onto our compass, we were able to draw our circle. And with that, we wrap up our circles constructions worksheet. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments below. And if you haven't done so already, like, subscribe, and share.